Hey everyone, this is a guitar tutorial for All My Life by Taya Gaukrodger. Before we begin, please consider subscribing to my channel or give this video a like and comment below on what else you want to see in the future. Additionally, if you're interested in any of the gear that you see today, there are links in the description below. All right, grab your acoustic guitar and a capo and let's get started. All right, so you'll notice my capo is on the first fret. We're going to be playing in the key of G to match the original key, which is A flat or G sharp. You're going to need to know the following chords: G, D, E minor, C, F, A7, B7, and D over F sharp. All right, so let's go over how I play those specific chords now. You're going to need to play this version of G for the first chord you play. Now, technically, the keyboard starts this song, so we really don't play the intro, but the chords will be on screen for you, so you really don't get to play the fancy part as well as the outro, but if you have to, they'll be on screen for you. All right, so here's how I play G. Use your middle finger on the low E string, 3rd fret, index finger A string, 2nd fret, and then put your pinky on the high E, 3rd fret. Make sure to leave your B string open. Now that's technically the first chord of the song for you as a guitar player. Remember, the keys have the intro. For C, you can play it two different ways. Kind of keep that same shape for that G, but now you can put your ring finger down on the B string, 3rd fret. Keep your pinky on the high E, 3rd fret also, but put your middle finger on the A string, 3rd fret, index finger on the D string now, 2nd fret, and avoid strumming the low E. That's a C2, and you'll use that in the chorus. But for the verse, use this version of C. Put your index finger on the B string, 1st fret, middle finger, D string, 2nd fret, and your ring finger on the A string, 3rd fret. Avoid strumming the low E for this one also. And there you go. That's really a traditional C chord shape, and that will be in the verses. Now, the F chord is very similar to C, so you're going to put your pinky on the D string, 3rd fret, lift off on your middle finger, now put it on the G string, 2nd fret. And that's the F chord that will be used in this song. You don't have to bar the F, but if you wanted to, you could. The next one is E minor. You could put your index finger and middle fingers on the 2nd fret, A and D strings respectively. Now put your pinky down on the high E, 3rd fret, and that's the E minor chord shape. For the D chord, put your index finger on the G string, 2nd fret, middle finger, 2nd fret also, high E, and then B string is covered on the 3rd fret with your ring finger. This is the D chord, but avoid strumming the low E and A strings. Now, for the last chorus, you want to keep your pinky down. This is technically a D suspended chord, but that's what I'm hearing on the recording. Two more chords. Last two are the fancy ones. A7 is just your index finger on the D string, 2nd fret, and then you're going to skip a string, put your ring finger on the B string, 2nd fret also, and you're leaving the G string open for this. Strum the A string down. That's A7, and then B7. Put your middle finger on the A string, 2nd fret, index finger on the 1st fret, D string, ring finger on the G string, 2nd fret, and then your pinky goes down on the high E, 2nd fret also. It looks very weird, but you can do it, and just try to go slow and build it up just like I did. So practice those chord shapes before you play along with the song. I'll put the chords on screen for you. I'll say the chords as we go along, and afterwards I'll go over some strumming patterns for you. Now remember, I'm going to play as if I'm playing the exact same thing that the recording has, or at least very, very similar to it. I'm not going to play every chord that you see, just to help keep pace with what I would do for a full band situation. All right, get ready. Here we go. E minor, B7, G, A7, C, G. When my G. C, G, F, C, G, C, G, C, G, F, C, G, F, C, G. D, C, G, E minor, D, B7, G, A7, C, G, G, C, G, F, C, G, C, G, C, G, F, C, G, F, C, G, E minor, D, C, G, E minor, D, C, G, E minor, D, C, G, D over F sharp, E minor. A7, C, G, C, G, C, G, C, A7, C, G, E minor, D, C, G, E minor, D, C, A7, C, G, E minor, E7, G, A7, C, G. Well, everyone, I hope that I was able to help you out with that tutorial. So let's go over some strumming patterns very quickly. And we'll start with the chorus. And I'm going to start with the last chorus because it's actually kind of fun and the acoustic is really featured there. So remember, on this chorus, we're playing D suspended technically and not just D. And you might argue that that happens on every chorus, and I might side with you on that now that I listened to it and played through it again. So it's up to you if you want to use that D suspended every time or just save it for the last chorus. But anyway, here's the strumming pattern that I'm using, starting on E minor. So really just an eighth note strumming pattern here. And really you have to be careful with changing to G because it happens on an offbeat. For example, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So I think it's on the end of 2 that's when you're changing to G. So just be careful with that, and it happens really on every chorus no matter what you're playing. But when you get to the third line of the chorus, every chord is straight, and then you have the D over F sharp, which begs the question, I don't know if I actually taught you that. So D over F sharp is simple. You just put your index finger on the second fret, low E string, middle finger on the G string, second fret also, then put your ring finger on the B string, third fret, and that's D over F sharp. And it only happens once in every chorus. If you can't get the F sharp version of it, you can just play a regular D and the bass player can carry the F sharp for you. Let's jump to the bridge. There is a moment that you don't play at all and you're just kind of blunting the strings. It's pretty cool, and not many worship songs have this, at least exclusively for the acoustic guitar anymore. So props to Taya for using this, but this is how I would use that strumming pattern. Kind of like an offbeat pattern, and it may not be perfectly what the recording is doing, but you could do something that's very similar or create your own, but you don't want to get in the way of other instruments because really no instruments are playing there. It's just the voices. So don't get in the way of the voices. Once again, I'll play that a little slower. something like that, but you don't have to do exactly what I'm doing. It probably is wrong. So it's very hard for me to explain strumming pattern. I love talking about chords, but strumming pattern, not really. Next up, the verses, you can do something like this. And notice that I'm kind of strumming up when I have to change, because again, a lot of the chord changes in the verses are on off beats. So I'll play that a little slower, and notice I'm playing my G chord a little differently than what I taught you. I'm sorry, my pinky's still on the bottom string, but I'm gonna just shift my top two fingers around. Now my middle finger's covering the A string second fret, and my ring finger's on the lower string. It's easier to switch to C that way, at least for me. Maybe it is for you. So I'll strum a little slower now. Something very similar to that, and again, you don't have to do it exactly the way I'm doing it, but maybe that'll help you. All right, thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit that like button, comment below on what else you want to see in the future, and I have to leave you off with this really cool story. I actually met Taya one time. My wife and I won tickets to see Hillsong United, and we got to see the backstage a little bit, VIP passes to meet two of the bandmates, Jonathan Douglas, or JD, and Taya, of course, and it was really cool to meet them. Both of them were very humble, and I'm very excited to see that she's producing music, continuing to still produce music in 2022. So props to her, and praying that her music continues to impact people just like how she did with Oceans and so many other songs. Thanks again for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel once more. I have to put that plug in and hit that like button. And of course, comment below on what else you want to see in the future. All right, thanks, guys. Have a great week. God bless.